Ready to tank predictions again? How about no more prediction vids? Cause geez, OGA was awful. It can't go much worse than your OGA predictions. Best of luck. Thank goodness your bracket is busted and BDS isn't gonna win. I disliked for Liquid. Take a deep breath. It's easy. You need to make the right call.
The Susquehanna Soniqs are your USN champion. Finally, after waiting since April... That is a fire truck. Can you hear the fire truck? Because I can hear the fire truck. After waiting since the start of this tournament all the way back in April, we are about to find out who will be crowned Team USA 2019. And there is a 12.5% chance it could be won by 2 euros. Nice. The United States Nationals Finals are being held this weekend, December 14th and the 15th, at the Penn & Teller Theater in Las Vegas, Nevada. The exact same place it was being held last year. And thanks to Rogue essentially disintegrating into thin air, we no longer have a storyline in involving a defending United States champion. We will effectively crown a new Team USA when the dust settles on Sunday. This is the first LAN event for North American teams after the shuffle last month to see how their new rosters shake out in a more competitive environment. Even though the stakes and the prize pool aren't nearly as great as Pro League competition, which lessens the chance of some of these pros potentially taking the event seriously, it's still better than scrims. So we can get a good first look at what these squads will promise for future competition in the region. All qualifiers were held online in broadcasts on the official Rainbow Six Twitch channel, which began back in April and ran all the way through November. We have Team Reciprocity, the Susquehanna Soniqs, Space Station, Evil Geniuses, Luminosity, Tempo Storm, Dark Zero, and TSM. Because they replace Rogue despite their death even after being eliminated in these qualifiers themselves. So let's break down these games before I break my monitor mount, Jesus Christ. But before I do, I need everyone here to be aware that I don't care if my predictions are 100% right or so utterly wrong you'd think I was ninjas in pajamas thinking they'd succeed more with Gohan, or that King George is actually a good player. I'm basing my predictions on previous expectations, which is oftentimes tainted if a team has a roster switch right before an event, which in this case happened with everybody except Tempo and Space Station. So take everything I say with a massive grain of salt because I clearly don't know what I'm talking about.
BDS takes it.
Shut up. We'll begin at the top of the bracket. Our first quarterfinal is the newly relegated Susquehanna Soniqs. Susquehanna, Susquehini, Sweetie Bantu. Against Tempo Storm. There is something to be said, especially within North America, of teams sticking with the same roster. They have a lot of confidence that that roster can succeed as the five stack that they are. In this case, both Tempo and the Soniqs have had basically the same rosters for the past couple of months, even though the Soniqs had some problems with Slebin and Gonfi with ESL and work visa issues and whatnot. These teams have relatively stayed the same for the past little bit. Even before Tempo was picked up by the org and they were known as Two-Faced, it was still relatively the same team. And unlike most of the other teams that are in this tournament, the whole "I made a roster switch so I might not be as good as I once was" card doesn't really apply to this match. You have to figure that there was a real reason for why Slebin and Gonfi were replacing both Avian and Ghost. It doesn't really make sense for them to just be brought in from Europe other than for the lulz. There's clearly a reason why they're over here. And granted, if they had had a little bit more time under the Pro League umbrella or had been able to play right at the start of the second half of the split, chances are they may not have been relegated. Right now, I don't really know if this move is working out for them because I think Tempo Storm takes this match. Just as though there is merit to the idea that the Soniqs just got relegated, so then is there also merit to the idea that Tempo Storm is now a brand new Pro League team because they had to beat a Pro League team to get there. So I think this is Tempo's game. It's probably a 2-1. If they actually go on to win this entire tournament, I swear to God, the subreddit is going to implode because Super finally won something. Quarterfinal number 2 is Space Station Gaming against Dark Zero. This is probably where I'm taking a really wild swing and not just going with a safe bet because in this case, I don't really know if there is a safe bet. Dark Zero is dealing with two roster changes with Skies and Eclipse being moved onto the team, and Space Station already has had Canadian in for a little while. They just made the grand finals at the OGA Pitminer despite not winning, and I think they do win this match. I think Dark Zero is knocked out in the quarterfinals. They just haven't really had enough time to settle in with their roster at this stage. Despite the mistakes that they showed at OGA Pit, I think there's a chance that they come from Croatia to Vegas a week later, still on a hot streak and still hopping mad that they lost to Team Liquid in the finals. And even though though OGA is just VOD fodder for Dark Zero, who can find a way to effectively counter-strat it, they will ultimately turn out the victors. I think DZ needs a little bit more time to settle in with Eclipse and Skies before they're really ready for prime time. We'll probably see them perform better in Pro League than we will here. Quarterfinal number 3, Reciprocity against LG. This is another one that's really hard to call. Luminosity went further than I thought they were going to go in OGA pit, and that's mostly due to how Slash has kind of turned that team's mentality around a little bit. But something you have to remember is that Rek now has Vertical. I think there were lots of people that were questioning or overlooking the team changes that Rek made by grabbing Nyx and grabbing Vertical and making some changes to how they play. I think this is probably where Rek may be able to shine the brightest. And as excited as I am to see how Dark Zero works with these new roster transitions, I think that it may work out faster for Rek just because of the talent that they've brought in. And I think LG is a little bit on the short end of the stick here. It's gonna be really weird to watch Slash kill Vert or vice versa. After the two of them have been on a squad for so long, that's... oh man, I don't know if my poor NA heart can take this. And one more quarterfinal on day one is TSM against EG. I'm sorry, I can't pick TSM. Even though I did roast EG a little bit by saying that Gacha was not the right player to replace Geo and that having Geo leave in the first place was probably a really bad idea, I think that what EG currently has is a pretty darn good team just from a numbers perspective. They've still got a good core in Young, NVK, and Necrox. Modiga is a ridiculous fragger, and Gacha, despite not being a Geo replacement, is still a really good player in his own right. That should still be a good contender for North America, and there's a reason why I think TSM falls short. It's because Pojo Man's not there. Timzy is subbing in for him. I don't remember if it was because Pojo couldn't get a visa or just didn't. And if you cast your mind back to the USN qualifiers, when TSM was playing, they were playing with Crazy, and Crazy can't sub in anymore because now he plays for Tempo Storm. So having Timzy as a sub, having Geo in for his first event with the team at LAN, I think it's kind of a bad 1-2 punch. And I think Gacha has previous history with EG, you know, being their coach. And he even subbed in at the USN finals in 2018. Right now, I think TSM shows a lot of promise, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what they can do in Season 11. But for the purpose of this tournament, I think this is an EG match. Feel free to roast me on Twitter. Like, just go for it. I'm fully expecting Bolo to just unfollow me straight out of the gate. Quarterfinals wrap up day one, and day two is both the semifinals and the grand final. To the best of my knowledge, all of these matches are also best of threes, because that's a pretty standard format for ESL tournaments. Through this bracket, our first semifinal is Tempo Storm versus SSG. Whoever wins the first quarterfinal between Tempo and the Soniqs, I don't think beats the winner of SSG versus Dark Zero. Therefore, in this case, I don't think Tempo Storm beats SSG. I think there's a lot more experience on SSG. I think they've got better coaching staff. They have more org support. Tempo just recently inked a deal in Pro League. They're just starting to really get their bearings. I don't see Tempo Storm making it with the juggernaut that is Space Station standing in their way. And I genuinely believe that despite all the traveling they have to do, you know, the jet lag, the fact that some of them might have gotten sick, I really do think that that's something that they can push through and use as fuel to punch through the rest of the teams in this tournament. I think SSG... hold on, I'll save that for the last prediction. Give me a second. Semifinal number 2, Evil Geniuses against Reciprocity. I really don't want to use the excuse of I just have a gut feeling to explain how predictions are going to go down. I'd much prefer to back it up with, you know, facts or more logic or something like that. But in this case, I don't really know if EG has what it takes. I'm picking Rek. It's weird to explain why, if only because there might still be some synergy issues between EG and Gacha, or just how their roster shapes up after Gacha's addition. But the exact same thing can be said for Rek, because they're having two new people come in. I'm taking Rek. I really can't explain why.
But joke's on you. This is my show, and I don't need to explain it if I don't want to.
So with that, we wrap everything up with our grand final. Space Station Gaming against Team Reciprocity. And this is where I'm finally going to allow those brand new roster moves to catch up with Reciprocity. This just isn't their weekend. I think Space Station are your USN 2019 champions, and I'm going against the Canadian curse. It's not at Pro League, it's not the Major, it's not the Invitational. I think he finally gets a win at a LAN event since when? continuum at 2017. I don't even remember the last time he won a LAN event. Sorry if this wasn't as detailed an explanation as you may have been looking for. This is legitimately a really hard tournament to try to call matches on, mainly because so many of them have the same problems and they're really evenly matched because in my head, I can't quantify how good a team is until I've seen them in more LAN performances. And with all of these roster changes that have happened for the NA Shuffle a couple of weeks back, it makes me wonder just how prepared teams are coming in with only a couple of weeks exposure with new players on the roster. We'll see how everything turns out this weekend, and in my opinion, this is really Space Station's event to lose. Even though I said that at the last LAN, I will reiterate that statement here. And one last thing to keep in mind is, because it's a national tournament, it's being run by ESL, but it isn't Pro League, you know, be prepared for the performances that you see from teams and players here might not live up to the same standards as Pro League or international competition, just because the stakes in this case aren't nearly as high. And I think, you know, everyone might have the same mentality of it being kind of like a glorified scrim on LAN, because it really doesn't mean anything in the end. You're not fighting for an invitational spot. It's not a minor, it's just a national tournament. So they're not fighting for what they would fight for if they were in a Pro League finals event. So just something to keep in mind. That's gonna do it for me. I didn't make a video on the Sisu roster situation, even though I did see the news that they're going to add players in from Kekona and still keep their spot in Challenger League. They're in Challenger League now and not in Pro League, and I wanted to make sure that I got this video up first, just because this tournament matters a lot to fans within North America. So if I talk about the Sisu roster change at some point, it'll just be kind of in like a roundup video later. Hit up my Twitter, my Twitch, and this YouTube channel for more in the coming days. Please and thank you, and I'll see you later. Peace!